Welcome to Mount Van Hovenberg for the biathlon competition. This is the women's 10K pursuit. This is one of the most exciting forms of biathlon in that the start times are determined by performance in yesterday's competition. The winner was Anna Nesda Kurumidikek with a gold medal. Shiloh Russo from Canada took the silver medal. And Teresa Yandova took the bronze. Now, Yandova, you see how exhausted she was yesterday. Teresa Yandova has decided that she is too fatigued and needs a break. The cutoff point, or the wave that will then go, is around 4 minutes. So anyone who's over 4 minutes will go all together at the same time. As we line up with the empty start gate there for lane three for Teresa Yandova. We're off and we're running, and the pole, Anna Nesda Kurumidikek is off and running. So Shiloh Russo will go 24 seconds. And Russo off. Of course, no Teresa Yandova. But Shiloh Russo, if she can shoot well here, has a very good opportunity to ski out a good lead. So no Yandova. And it is Anna Blanc of France that will go off with a 45-second deficit. Blanc has started. And then going at a minute, 3, 5, 8, and 9, we've got the Kazakhstani Polina Yegorova, Kristina Kozova, Barbara Skrovchevska, and Yulia Horodna from Ukraine. So Kazakhstan, Czech, Poland, and Ukraine are in a little group that will be chasing down Anna Blanc. We're seeing Shiloh Russo here from Canada. So she is chasing down number one there, the pole. And now we'll get to see the difference. It was 24 seconds. There's the Kurumidikek. It's going to be around about the same, isn't it? So Russo maybe just losing a fraction. Yeah, 24.8. Well, losing 8/10 of a second. It's pretty much nothing in it between the Pole and the Canadian. They are where they were. Now, a penalty loop is around about 24 seconds. So if Russo can shoot clean and the Pole, Nesda Kurumidikek, drops a target, then they will probably be leaving the range at about the same time. If they both shoot clean, then the advantage will stay as it is. So the first shot will be from the prone position. Come into the range. So first to shoot, it is Nesda Kurumidikek. Just getting the breaths in. settling down. First shot good. Taking a couple more breaths. This is good shooting from the pole. See the breaths just moving the rifle around, and a clean first attempt there from the pole. And Russo now will need to be clean if she wants to stay in touch. One miss there from Shiloh Russo. So that 24-second deficit will increase and could well double as we get the chasers come in. Ukraine, Kazakhstan, Poland, Czech, France there. Blanc just settling in, closest to the screen, and not shooting quickly and missing a target. So clean from the pole, Barbara Skrobinchevska. So Skrobinchevska. Russo has come out of the range, 54 seconds down on the leading pole, Nezda Kurabinacek, with that one penalty loop skied. Okovska's dropped a couple of seconds on the track. And Skrobinchevska has dropped about 6 seconds on the current leader. So Nezda Kurabinacek is skiing one of the fastest and is leading this competition. And if she can shoot clean here, it might well get to a stage where she could afford even one or two misses. So a lead of around about 54 seconds into shooting two. It's the second time that she will be in the prone position. Getting the breaths in. Now steadies, shoots. It's good. A couple more breaths. Shoots. Well, that's the first miss for the pole. And it's two misses right now. That could open things up. And there's a Kurabinacek will go off and do those two penalty loops. Now, Russo will not know what is going on in front of her. It's really all about making sure that she goes through the process, takes out the magazine, the spent magazine, replaces it with the third magazine for the second shoot. If Russo can go clear, then they will be pretty much the same as they come out of the range. Oh, she's dropped one. Okovska's dropped one as well. So Skrobinchevska, who's skiing a fraction slower, has dropped one as well. In fact, make that two. So disappointment there for the second pole, Barbara Skrobinchevska. She will have to do two penalty loops. In fact, both of the poles having to ski around twice. But already out onto the track, it's Nezda Kurabinacek. Two misses, but Russo couldn't capitalize on that. Russo actually shooting faster and skiing the penalty loops faster. She's out of the shooting range too, only 26 seconds back. So there is a current leader, started with bib one and is hanging on to that lead through the 5.6 kilometer mark, 17 minutes, 26 seconds. Now, what's the deficit? Was 26 seconds. It's definitely closed up. And Russo has taken 6 seconds off the Polish leader. And it did look to me that Nedzer Kurobinacek was perhaps slowing slightly, whereas Russo looked strong and powerful there. So here comes the leader, and she's really struggling. She does look to be tiring. So into the range. So the first shot from the standing position. So we'll need to shoot clean to guarantee that that lead will remain. A single miss and things could get quite close. So the Polish leader, not seeing her on screen there. I'm looking, she's missed the first. She's got the second. We're picking her up now. So first missed, second good, third good, fourth good. And a miss, so two misses for Nedzer Kurobinacek as we see Russo. Russo going clear so far. Otkowska's missed two. And make that three for the Czech skier, but Russo's clear. Russo's gone clean, a smile on the Canadian's face there. That was a great performance on the range. Now, will she take the lead as she leaves? Well, she must do, yes. She will take the lead. The Canadian now moves into gold medal position. It could be another gold for Shiloh Russo. Silver yesterday, gold in the sprint. So Russo, well, she was given that opportunity by Anna Nedzer Kurobinacek. And what is the time that the pole trails? 33 seconds behind. So Russo now in pole position over the pole. So two misses from standing. And Russo snatched the opportunity when it was presented to her. So Russo with two misses in total is leading the poll. Anna Nedzer Kurobinacek with four misses. Going into third from Ukraine, it's Yulia Horodna wearing bib eight. She's 59 seconds back. Shiloh Russo took the gold in the women's 12.5 short individual. Yesterday took silver in the women's 7.5 kilometer sprint. And it's going well again for Russo. Spoke to Aha after the race yesterday and she said that on the descents she was having to take it really carefully. Did not want to crash. There was a few that did go down. It was really slushy, difficult conditions, and there was a big, long, steep descent. It's a slightly different course that they're racing today. They don't have that high-speed, right-footed turn because there's a little cut through here where you drop down a steep hill and you rejoin at this point where the 2.5 kilometer course came around. And Russo just has the inside line there on her teammate, who is being lapped. So approaching the 7.6 kilometer split time. Russo had a lead of 33 seconds over Nitza Kurobiniec. And I think that that could well extend. Russo seems to be skiing quickly here. So bib 11. Victoria Salchinska doing well, moving up. As we see Russo. This is not Russo, this is the pole. So across 39 seconds. So that lead for Russo has extended from 33 to 39. And Russo, when they both did the first couple of laps, Russo was around about the same speed, but I think that Nesda Kurobiniec has just dropped off ever so slightly in her ski speed as we're watching a battle between bib number 8, Horodna of Ukraine, against the pole, Salchinska. And Salchinska, good speed on the course. So Russo comes in to the final, the fourth and final shoot, and she knows that a clear shoot here, and she has a 39 second lead. Clear will guarantee her the gold. Good so far. Two from three. Oh, there was a miss for Russo. Russo's missed one. Russo, you didn't see it on the screen, but Russo's got a penalty loop. One missed. It was the second last shot that Russo missed there. So Russo will have to do a penalty loop. She does have the time to get that penalty lap skied and get out in front, even if her chasers were to go clear now. So coming in wearing bib number 1 is Anna Nedza Kurobiniec, as we watch number 8 there, Yulia Horodna. So I can tell you that Nedza Kurobiniec is in the range and shooting, and she's missed one. Solchinska, bib number 3. And Yulia Horodna, bib number 8, misses one. Horodna missing two there. This is for potential silver or bronze medal. Salchinska, can she go clear? Salchinska has gone clear and will get out onto the track. So the difference there, Russo is well out in front, just two misses in total, and 40 seconds her lead over Nedza Kurobiniec, as we watch some of the trailing biathletes come in through the field. These biathletes will not be troubling for the podium. So it's Russo that's in the gold medal position, with Anna Nedza Kurobiniec in second at 40 seconds back as they left the range. Victoria Salchinska of Poland is in third place, 1 minute 14 back. And the other pole, Barbara Skrobczewska, is lying in fourth place, with Horodna back in fifth. So the gold medal will go to Shiloh Russo. And you can see the times there. It's quite a comfortable gap between gold and silver and between silver and bronze. There is the silver medal position. Russo coming round onto the finish straight. Oh, a little stumble. And that was it. Taking the Canadian flag. That was the stumble. It was her taking her pole off so she could grab the Canadian flag. And the second gold medal, third medal of these games. Silver yesterday, and it is gold today in the pursuit for Shiloh Russo of Canada. A great ski in the end. And good work on the range. Just three misses for Russo. And gold medalist yesterday takes the silver today. It's going to be the pole, Barbara Skrobczewska, and it's going to take this. It was a real battle for the bronze. Skrobczewska taking bronze over Otowska of the Czech Republic and Solczynska of Poland, all finishing within just a few seconds of each other.
Winter World University Games.
Yulia Horodna just crossing the line, wearing bib number 8, just maybe conserving some of her energy for the final event, which will be the mass start competition in a couple of days' time. Polina Yegorova of Kazakhstan, again just dropping back from that number 5 start spot. So a great day for Poland, but even better day for Canada. Shiloh Russo, winner of the women's 10K pursuit competition. Shiloh Russo takes her second gold medal. Anna Nedza Kurobiniec in silver, and Barbara Skrobczewska of Poland in bronze.
Shiloh Russo!